little-known traditional folk theatre forms of India. Kudiyattam. One of the oldest traditional theatre forms of India, Kudiyattam follows the performative principles of the ancient tradition of Sanskrit theatre. However, it has its own distinctive characteristics that are firmly rooted in the culture of Kerala. This theatre was traditionally a part of temple rituals performed in sacred theatres called Kuthambalams. In 2001, Kudiyattam was officially recognized by UNESCO as a masterpiece of the oral and intangible heritage of humanity. Yakshagana. Yakshagana is a popular folk theatre form of Karnataka with a long history of nearly 400 years. It is a unique harmony of musical tradition, eye-catching costumes, and authentic styles of dance, improvised gestures and acting, with its extemporaneous dialogue holding a wide appeal. The themes are generally derived from the mythological stories and epics. Traditionally presented from dusk to dawn, this folk theatre is predominantly seen in the coastal districts of Karnataka. Swam. A popular folk theatre form in Haryana, Rajasthan and Uttar Pradesh. Swam is centered around music. In this folk theatre, religious stories and folk tales are enacted and sung by a group of a dozen or so artists. Characterized by loud rendering of dialogues and songs, a legacy of its open-air performances in the past, Swam has two important styles, one that belong to Rohtak performed in the Bangru language, and the other that belongs to Hathras performed in the Braj Bhasha language. Bhand Pata. The centuries-old traditional theatre form of Kashmir, Bhand Pather, is a unique combination of dance, music and acting. Satire, wit and parody are commonly used in this folk drama that incorporates local mythological legends and contemporary social commentary. Traditionally, the performances begin in the evening with a ritualistic dance called Chok. The play unfolds gradually after this and ends in the early hours of the morning. Interestingly, the performers or bhands dance to the tune of specific instruments like the mukam, swarni, dhol and nagara. Ankiya Nat Bhona. Bhona is a presentation of the Ankiya Nat, a one-act play that has its roots in rural Assam. A creation of Srimanta Sankardeva, an Assamese saint scholar. These plays were written in Brajavali, a unique Assamese Mathili mixed language, and are primarily centered on Hindu deity Krishna. The dialogues, costumes, ornaments, entry and foot movements of Bhona are unique and set this theatre form apart from others in India. Tamasha. A traditional folk theatre form of Maharashtra, Tamasha flourished in the courts of Maratha rulers of the 18th and 19th centuries and attained its artistic peak during the reign of Baji Rao. It has evolved from the folk forms such as Gondhal, Jagran and Kirtan. Unlike other theatre forms, in Tamasha, the female actress is the lead performer and the chief exponent of dance in the play. Classical music, the lightning-fast footwork of the Lavani dance, and vivid gestures of the performers gives this folk theatre a distinctive character. Thirukuthu. A unique form of rural entertainment in Tamil Nadu, Thirukuthu literally means street theatre. Some influence of classical Sanskrit drama on it is apparent. Performed in the open, mostly during temple festivals in villages, this theatre primarily draws from mythological stories and epics. The performance includes lively dances and songs sung in a high pitch by the male actors, Even the female roles are played by males who wear wide colorful costumes, sparkling shoulder plates, elaborate head dresses and thick bright makeup. Jatra. The Jatra, also popular in Orissa and eastern Bihar, originated in Bengal in the 15th century as a result of the Bhakti movement. It was initially known as Krishna Jatra due to Chaitanya, spiritual founder of Gaudiya Vaishnavism influence. Over the years, the Jatra repertoire swelled with love stories and socio-political themes. While initially this theater was primarily musical, today, Jatra performances consist mainly of action-packed dialogues with few songs. Bhavai. Bhavai is the traditional theater form of the Kutch and Kathiawar region of Gujarat. Subtle social criticism laced with humor is the speciality of this theater, that also uses instruments like the bhungal, pakhavaj, rabab, sarangi and manjira. This folk theater is as much a dramatic form of entertainment as it is a kind of ritual offering made to the Hindu goddess Amba. The genesis of Bhavai is traced back to a 14th century Brahmin priest, Asita Thakur, who is believed to have written as many as 360 Bhavai performances, out of which only 60 survive today. Dashavatar. Dashavatar is a folk theatre form practiced by farmers of the Konkan coast, especially in the Sindhudurg district of Maharashtra and the North Goa district of Goa. In Dashavatar, the performers personify the 10 incarnations of Vishnu, the Hindu god Vishnu of preservation and creativity: Matsya, Kurma, Varaha, Narsimha, Vaman, Parashuram, Rama, Krishna, Buddha and Kalki. It is traditionally performed after midnight during the annual festival of the village deity. Apart from stylized makeup, the Dashavatar performers also wear masks of wood and papier-mâché. The performance is accompanied by three musical instruments: a paddle harmonium, tabla and zanj. Karyala. A traditional folk theatre form of Himachal Pradesh, Karyala is normally performed around the Dashehra festival, in October to November, with local variants all over Himachal Pradesh. Karyala generally derives its theme from the daily life and concerns of the villagers. The open-air performance is prefaced by virtuoso drumming, uses minimal props and often incorporates dance and comic acts. Ramman. Ramman is a ritual theater that is a part of a religious festival in the Gadwal region of Uttarakhand. Every year in late April, the twin villages of Salur Dingdar in the state of Uttarakhand, northern India, celebrate a religious festival in honor of the village deity, Bhumiyal Devta. An eponymous art form unique to these villages, Ramman is made up of highly complex rituals that involve the recitation of a version of the epic Ramayana and various legends. This is also accompanied by the performance of local songs and masked dancers.